Hi, my name is Monika, and in this video I would like to tell you a bit about the Polish alphabet, but I won't focus on the names of the letters. Instead, I will focus on the sounds that you produce when reading words containing specific letters, because it might happen that one letter might represent more than one sound, and sometimes there might be a case that two letters next to each other produce a different sound. So let's now go one by one through all the letters in the Polish alphabet, and I will tell you what kind of sounds it will make. Additionally, I will give you some examples of words containing these letters. So the first letter would be A. A. Like in the words aparat. Aparat. Kawa. Kawa. Mama. Mama. The next one is om. Om. This is a nasal vowel produced through the nose. Om. Om. Like in the words song. Song. Kąt. Kąt. Mąką. Mąką. Moving forward, we have b, 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 as in banan, banan, kubek, kubek. This letter, however, might be also said as p, p. It will be when it is next to a voiceless consonant or at the end of the word, such as chleb. Chleb. Here the b is at the end of the word, so we say p, chleb, chleb. And in the example żabka, żabka, here again the b is actually pronounced as p because it's next to k, and k is a voiceless consonant. By the way, what is a voiceless consonant? A voiceless consonant like it's voiceless, so we don't have any vibration in the throat while producing the sounds. In the contrary, we have voiced consonants such as b, g, v, z. Then there is kind of a vibration while you produce these sounds. So remember, if b is next to a voiceless consonant, then it becomes p, żabka. Then the next sound would be ts, ts, like in the words cena, cena, praca, praca, noc, noc. If you have ts next to ch together, the sound would be ch, ch, like choć. Choć. Chleb. Chleb. Trochę. Trochę. If c is next to z, then it becomes cz. Cz. Like czas. Czas. Kaczka. Kaczka. Lecz. Lecz. If ts is next to i, all together it makes a sound chi, chi, like in the words ciemny, ciemny, leci, leci. Next we have ch, ch, like in the words ćma. Ćma. Żyć. Żyć. By the way, a lot of infinitive forms of the verbs end in ć, like żyć, pić, jeść, right? Then the next letter is D.
D.
As in dom.
Dom.
Rada.
Rada.
But if you find this letter at the end of the word, it becomes voiceless. T. T. Like lont.
Lont.
Or if it's next to a voiceless consonant, the same, it becomes voiceless. T. Like radca.
Radca.
This combination of letters is dz.
Dz.
Like in the words bardzo.
Bardzo.
Jedzenie.
Jedzenie.
And if these letters are at the end of the word or near a voiceless consonant, then it becomes ts.
Ts.
Like ksiądz.
Ksiądz.
Ludzki.
Ludzki.
Moving forward, this combination of three letters makes the sound G.
G.
Like dziwny.
Dziwny.
Tydzień.
Tydzień.
Chodzi.
Chodzi.
The next combination of letters makes the sound G.
G.
Like the word dźwięk.
Dźwięk.
Niedźwiedź.
Niedźwiedź.
And if it's at the end of the word, it becomes voiceless.
Ch, ch.
Choć.
Choć.
So here it's very important to be aware where these letters are located to be able to produce the right sound. Then moving forward, we have D.
D.
Like in the word dem.
Dem.
Jeżdżę.
Jeżdżę.
And again, if this sound is at the end of the word, it becomes voiceless.
Gwiszcz.
Gwiszcz. So it's tch.
Gwiszcz.
Or if it's next to a voiceless consonant, it becomes also voiceless. Przejażdżka.
Przejażdżka.
Then we have e.
E.
Like in the word ekran.
Ekran.
Ten.
Ten.
Nowe.
Nowe.
And here comes another nasal vowel.
L.
L. Like in the word pięć.
Pięć.
Or będę.
Będę.
Imię.
Imię.
Here, if it's at the end of the word, it's more like e than l. You won't exaggerate so much.
Imię.
Imię. Then we have f,
f,
like farba.
Farba.
Szafa.
Szafa.
Cliff.
Cliff.
Then we have g.
G.
Głowa.
Głowa.
Miga.
Miga.
And if this letter is at the end of the word, it becomes voiceless.
K.
K. Like ruk.
Ruk.
Next letter is ch.
Ch.
Hotel.
Hotel.
Wahać się.
Wahać się.
Druh.
Druh.
Then we have I.
I.
Like in the words idę.
Idę.
Mili.
Mili.
Lubi. Lubi. Then the next letter is y.
Y.
Like in the words ja.
Ja.
Jej.
Jej.
Maj.
Maj.
Then it's k.
K.
Like the word kto.
Kto.
Okno.
Okno.
Lekki.
Lekki.
This was actually an example where we have double K. Lekki. So you kind of make a pause on the K sound. Lekki. Some people will separate those sounds and say lekki.
Lekki.
Next we have L.
L.
Lody.
Lody.
Mleko.
Mleko.
Hotel.
Hotel.
And then this one is w.
W.
Ładny.
Ładny.
Mały.
Mały.
Miał.
Miał.
Then we have m.
M.
Miasto.
Miasto.
Komu.
Komu.
Tam.
Tam.
N.
N.
Na.
Na.
Ona.
Ona.
Wanna.
Wanna.
Again, a double consonant. It can be with a pause, wanna, or you can split it, wanna,
wanna.
Both can be heard. Then we have ni,
ni,
nic,
nic,
koniec,
koniec,
oni,
oni.
Ni,
ni.
Koń,
koń.
Słoń,
słoń.
Słońce,
słońce.
O,
o.
Osiem,
osiem.
Kot,
kot.
Okno,
okno.
And this one would be u,
u.
Ósemka.
Ósemka.
Mój.
Mój.
Góra.
Góra.
P. P. Pan.
Pan.
Stopa.
Stopa.
Hip-hop.
Hip-hop.
This letter actually is not a Polish one, but still you can find in some foreign words. And it will be pronounced in a similar way as in the original language. So, for example, squash.
Squash.
IQ.
IQ.
Next one is rr.
Rr.
So a very rolling rr.
Rock.
Rock.
Rura.
Rura.
Góra.
Góra. This combination is zh.
Zh.
Rzeka.
Rzeka.
Brzuch.
Brzuch.
But if you find this at the end of the word, it becomes voiceless. Sh.
Sh.
Like talerz.
Talerz.
Or, if it's next to a voiceless consonant, again it becomes sh.
Przepraszam.
Przepraszam. Then we have s.
S.
Sos.
Sos.
Jest.
Jest.
Sak.
Sak.
Double consonant. This combination is sz, sz. Szkoła, szkoła. Proszę, proszę. Masz, masz. Jeszcze, jeszcze. This combination makes the sound she, she. Silny, silny. Osiem, osiem. Wisi, wisi. Sz, sz. Środa, środa. Myślę, myślę. Dziś, dziś. Then we have t, t. Trochę, trochę. Tata, tata. But, but. U, u. Ulica, ulica. Tu, tu. Autobus, autobus. By the way, this is the same sound as u, same u, but written differently. So you need to learn in which words is u and in which words the other u. This letter is not a Polish letter, basically, but you can still find it in some foreign words that exist, basically, in some texts in Polish. And it will be pronounced in the similar way as in the original form, like CV, CV, DVD, DVD. This one is V, V, wielki, wielki. Kawa, kawa. But if you find it at the end of the word or next to a voiceless consonant, it becomes voiceless, f, f, like stuff, stuff. Ławka, ławka. And this one is also a letter that doesn't exist in the Polish alphabet, but still you can find it in some foreign words, like chromosome X, X. Or the name of the series, z archiwum X, z archiwum X. Moving forward, we have y, y, ty, ty. Były, były. Ryby, ryby. Next we have z, z. Zupa, zupa. Lizak, lizak. And if you find it at the end of the word or next to a voiceless consonant, it becomes voiceless, s, s, like wyraz, wyraz. Rozkaz, rozkaz. This combination makes a sound z, z, zima, zima. Jezioro, jezioro. Razi, razi. This one is z, z, źle, źle. Późno, późno. And if you find it at the end of the word or next to a voiceless consonant, it becomes voiceless, sh, sh. Weź, weź. Buźka, buźka. The last one would be ż, ż. Żart, żart. Może, może. If you find it at the end of the word or next to a voiceless consonant, you know what happens. It becomes also voiceless and it will sound as sh, sh, like in the words nóż, nóż, łóżko, łóżko. And by the way, this zh is the same sound as a combination of r, z, 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 it's the same sound. So you have to learn which words have this z and which ones the other z. Now let's have a summary. Let's go through all the sounds in one go. And I will highlight which ones have two possible ways of pronouncing. And also you will see those sounds that come out of a combination of two or three letters. Ah, ah, on, on, b, b, p, p, ts, ts, h, h, ch, ch, chi, chi, d, d, t, t, z, z, ts, ts, g, g, j, j, ch, ch, d, d.
L, L, F, 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 G, G, K, K, H, H, I, I, Yi, Yi. L, L, W, W, M, M, N, N, Ni, 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 O, O, U, U. R, R, Z, Z, Sh, Sh, S, S, Sh, Sh, She, She, U, U, V, V, F, F, E, E, Z, Z, S, S, J, 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 Z, Z, sh, sh.
So this would be the Polish alphabet. As you could see, we read the letters in a different way depending where they are located. So there are a lot of changes from a voiced to a voiceless consonant. The other thing that can happen is a combination of two or three letters, and again we have a different sound. If you are interested in finding out more how to produce specific sounds, you can also check out my other videos focusing on specific letters or combinations of letters. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye!